Hello friends, today's topic is basic operations in relational algebra. Last video में हम लोगों ने relational algebra देखा था. What is a relational algebra? And in a relational algebra, we have seen there are two types of operators. Basic or fundamental operator, derived operator. So in basic or fundamental operators, there are many operations. So we'll start with the first. Select operations. The select operation or selection operator is used for selecting subset of tuples according to given selection conditions. So select operations hai wo koi bhi table ke row pe kaam karta hai, tuples pe kaam karta hai according to given conditions. So it is used as an expression to choose tuples which meet the selection conditions. So jo condition di hai, accordingly it selects the tuples from the relations. So selection operator is a unary operator whose main function is to select the tuples from the relations. Jo tuples predicate ne diye hue conditions ko satisfy karte hai, those are the selected and then later it is displayed. So select operator is denoted by letter sigma. Okay, and notation is sigma p into bracket, there is a relation. Or you can say sigma, there is a condition. The condition is written accordingly, tuples are selected from the relation. So sigma is a predicate, R stands for the relation, which is actually a name of the table, and P stands for proposition. So in a condition or in a proposition, we can use a different operators like and, or, not. These are the logical operators. And there are some relational operators like equal to, not equal to, less than, greater than, less than, equal to, greater than, equal to. Such type of operators we can use here in prepositions or in predicates. So you can say that the select operation, it works on the rows. It works on the tuples of the relation. And it resembles to a where clause of the SQL. Okay, so in SQL, हमें पता है कि SQL में जो where clause होता है, वहाँ पे condition लिखी होती है, and according to that condition, those are selected. In a similar way, in a relational algebra, select operator is used. So we are talking about the relational algebra, and in a relational algebra, the data is represented in tabular. Data is always represented in tabular form. So we are using same table which we have used in last video. So wahi hum aage leke ja rahe hain, and we'll see the queries examples based on the selection operator. So first, select all the records from the table student. From student relation, we have to display all the records. So for that, okay, how will you write the query using selection operator? So here, the table name, it comes in the parenthesis. A relation name comes in the parenthesis. So here, we have to fetch all the records from the student table. It would be sigma in the parenthesis student. Second query is the display tuples of student table whose roll number is 3. So now we are working on roll number 3. Okay, so ye table mein se kiska roll number 3 hai, so it will select this tuple. We know the roll number here is this roll number is 3, so this tuple must be selected. Accordingly, again the student or the table name or relation name would come in parenthesis. There is a sigma sign. roll number equals to 3. Now this assignment operator, we are matching this 3 to the roll number attribute. So this would come in a predicate. This would come, this is a predicate which is a subscripted over here. So between sigma and the name of the table, there is a condition. So based on the condition from this table, rows would be selected. For third query, display tuples of students who is greater than 17 and lives in Mumbai. So according to this query, हमें पता है कि कौन से students जिनका age 17 से ज्यादा है. And now we are using AND operator. This is a logical operator. So and the same students should be living in Mumbai. So obviously दोनों condition match होने चाहिए. Age 17 से ज्यादा and उसकी जो city है वो मुंबई होनी चाहिए. Accordingly the output would be this tuple. Okay, the selection operator is selecting the tuple based on the conditions, and this is the query. Again, as you can see, student in parentheses and the condition is written the age greater than 17 and is represented as this city equals to Mumbai. Okay, this predicate, this condition would come between sigma operator and the student table name. Okay, so accordingly, if you execute, this is a mathematical expression, this would be executed. Okay, we can express the query in using a mathematical expression. So output of this query would be this tuple, where student roll number would be 2, name would be Bob, city would be Mumbai, age would be 18. Okay, so the selection operator is used for selecting the rows. If you go further, okay, there are more queries as you can see here. The select tuple from a relation student where name is the Raj. Okay, so name equals to Raj. So Raj is written here in a double quotes because it's a string character. If there is a number, you don't need to mention double quotes or single quotes. You just need to write the number. Again, select the tuple from relation student where student do not live in Mumbai. So the way we are writing the query is the same. Okay, the sigma operator indicates the selection operator. Okay, so on which attribute we are working? We are working on city, so that it should not be equal to Mumbai. Okay, so accordingly, in the condition, the city not equals to Mumbai, and from which table? Student table. That student table is written in parentheses. Then next query is a select tuple from a relation student where students living in Agra or greater than age greater than 16. So accordingly, it's a OR operator we are using. So age should be greater than 16, or city should be Agra from student table. So these conditions are written in between sigma and name of their relation. So in this way, okay, we can use the select operator in our in a relational algebra. यहाँ पे एक क्वेश्चन आता है, we are selecting the attributes, we are selecting the output, but we are not displaying it. For displaying it, we use the projection operator. Okay, so next operator is a projection operator, which is the first operator in a relational algebra. Okay, so again, projection operator or projection operation defines a relation that contains vertical subsets of the relation. As I told you, the selection operator works on the row of the relation, whereas the projection operator works on the columns of the relation. This operation shows a list of those attributes that we wish to appear in the result, and the rest of the attributes are eliminated from the table. Since the projection operator it works on the column, जो input table है उसमें से जो desired column है वही आपके output में आते हैं, and जो बाकी के columns है उन्हें वो eliminate करता है. जो बैकग्राउंड टेबल है, बैकग्राउंड में जो डेटा है, व्हिच इज फिजिकली स्टोर्ड ऑन द हार्ड डिस्क और एनी स्टोरेज डिवाइस, वो उसमें चेंज नहीं होता. जो आपको आउटपुट दिखने वाला है उसमें चेंज होता है. अगेन प्रोजेक्शन ऑपरेटर इज द यूनिटी ऑपरेटर एंड इज डिनोटेड बाय लेटर पाई. सो हियर दिस इज नोटेशन पाई a1 a2 a3 डैश 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 डॉट up to n, and into bracket, into parenthesis, there is a relation. So all those a1, a2, a3, up to an are the columns or attributes. So let's say it works only on columns. So a1, a2, a3, up to an are the columns or attributes of the relation. So the selection operator here, it is similar to ground in SQL, whereas this projection operator is very similar to select command. It corresponds to select command in SQL. So select command in SQL is used to select the columns from the output. In selection operator we have seen ki hamara output kya hota hai, it's a row, ek row hoti hai aur number of rows hoti hai. बट वो आउटपुट में से कौन से और कितने कॉलम्स दिखाने हैं ये कौन बताता है, प्रोजेक्शन ऑपरेटर बताता है. ओके, एक इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग हियर अबाउट द प्रोजेक्शन ऑपरेटर इज द डुप्लीकेट रोज आर ऑटोमेटिकली एलिमिनेटेड. ओके, ये हम आगे देखेंगे आगे की स्लाइड्स में कैसे वो डुप्लीकेट रोज को एलिमिनेट करता है. So again, this is a table. So display or project name of the students of student relation. तो ये table में से हमें खाली name column चाहिए. Okay. So here in the parenthesis there is a relation which is a student, and this is a pi indicates the projection operator is denoted by the pi operator. And in between there are the list of the columns or attributes. So in my output I want to display only name. मुझे खाली name ये column दिखाना है, तो ये दोनों के बीच में there would be a name. Okay, so it will display only this part, this column, which is displaying all the tuples. Okay. So जो name उसमें कौन कौन से रोज होगी, गीता, बॉब, राज, अलीना, सैम. सपोज इफ आई वांट टू डिस्प्ले एज, ओके, इंस्टेड ऑफ नेम, सो देयर इट वुड बी पाई एज सबस्क्रिप्ट में आएगा यहाँ पे, एंड पैरेंथेसिस में रिलेशन नेम. बट यहाँ पे एक डिफरेंस होगा, इट विल नॉट शो यू द ऑल द टपल्स फ्रॉम द टेबल. It will show you only distinct values. So age would be a column header, and it would show you only 17, 18, 16, and 19. Even though यार 16 double आ रहा है, दो बार आ रहा है, तो भी वो उसे एक ही बार दिखाएगा. And that's why, okay, it only shows you distinct values. तो suppose what happens if we try to display name and age of the students together. The way we age में चार ही tuples आएंगे या नहीं, क्योंकि अगर if we try to print age separately it would show you only four tuples, four rows, because 16 is occurred two times in a table. तो redundancy जो duplicate है वो निकाल दिया है. But name column at the five separate would be displayed. But what if we combine name and age, dono ko combinedly dikha, dono ko dikhaya to kya hoga? So it would show Name age, Geeta 17, Bob 18, Raj 16, Alina 16, Sam 19, like this. Like this, it would display your output. Third query is display name and city of students who is greater than 70. So ab tak hum log dekh rahe the, we want to display all the tuples in a selected columns. But hume abhi jo tuples hai उस पे फिल्टरिंग यूज करनी है, एंड दैट फिल्टरिंग एंड कंडीशंस कैन बी अप्लाइड यूजिंग सिलेक्ट ऑपरेटर। सो एक हमेशा एक चीज याद रखना, ये जो पाई ऑपरेटर है वो हमेशा सबसे लास्ट में अप्लाई होता है। तो पहले जो एग्जीक्यूशन होगा वो हमेशा अंदर से होगा। सो फर्स्ट इट विल सिलेक्ट स्टूडेंट्स who are greater than 17. So accordingly, there would be 18 and 19. Okay. So this row and this row would be selected. But ye rows mein there are four columns. Number, name, city, and age. To ye char column mein se kaun sa column dikhana hai, display karna hai aapko? That would be given by the pie operator. I want to show only name and city. So accordingly, this would be your output. Okay. So what if I think, what if I write a projection operator inside and outside there is a selection operator? Agar maine uska order change kar diya, to kya hoga? To wo case mein agar kya hoga? Suppose, what is the output of this? By name, city, students, the output would be like this. Okay, but what is this? It is selecting age which is greater than 17, but hamare output mein age hai hi kaha. So this is a wrong way. This is a wrong way of writing a mathematical expression. To hamesha ek cheez yaad rakhna ki jo pi operator hota hai wo hamesha bahar aata hai. Jaise SQL mein select सबसे ऊपर आता है, सिलेक्ट नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स, ओके, जैसे ही वैसे ही जो पाई ऑपरेटर है वो हमेशा बाहर की साइड आता है, ये हमेशा याद रखना, ओके।